Hello everyone. Now we will see in this video what is EBIT indifference level, EBIT indifference point or EBIT indifference level. And not only we will see how to calculate it, we will also see the importance of that EBIT indifference level, where it is used, how it is used. So all that we will see through a question, and the question is on calculation of EBIT indifference level and its relevance. So let me go to a question state. Okay, so here is the question. Company has a requirement of additional funds of rupees 20 lakhs and company has two options in front of it. One option is it can raise this 20 lakhs either by way of equity 70% and remaining 30% by way of debt. And option two, it can raise equity 50% by 50% equity and remaining 50% debt. So these are the two options available in the market for the company. If debt is raised, then it will come at an interest of 11% per annum. And there is a corporate tax rate of 25%. And if company wants to issue the shares, then each share will be issued at rupees 100 each. So this is the question. Now company has to decide whether it should go for option 1 or whether it should go for option 2. So how to decide that? For that, EBIT indifference level is important. So what is EBIT indifference level? Let me first tell you that. So EBIT indifference level is that amount of EBIT at which EPS remains same regardless of whatever capital structure you decide to have. So whether you go for option 1 or whether you go for option 2, at that particular EBIT amount, your EPS will remain the same. So it won't matter to the company from shareholder's perspective whether the fund should be raised 70-30 equity versus debt or 50-50. So how to calculate that EBIT indifference level? The calculation of EBIT indifference level happens through simultaneous equation method. So let us say that this EBIT indifference level is rupees X. So what will happen? At this X rupees, we are saying EPS will remain same whether company goes for option 1 or whether company goes for option 2. So in both these options, EBIT is going to be X rupees, right? What will be the interest portion if company goes for option 1? Now 20 lakhs is the amount of overall funds required. In option 1, company is raising 30% by debt. And on this 30%, there will be interest of 11%. So 66,000. That will be the interest. And similarly, in option 2, 20 lakhs is the overall amount. 50% is going to be raised by debt, and on that 11% interest. So 1,10,000. So that will be the interest amount, all annual amounts. So profit before tax will be this minus this, this minus this. Tax is 25% as given in the question. So of these two amounts, 25% will be tax. So obviously remaining 75% will be profit after tax, correct? And then how do you calculate EPS, earnings per share, profit after tax divided by the number of equity shares? So this amount divided by number of equity shares. So if company is going for option 1, then 20 lakhs into 70%, because 70% will be raised by way of equity. And each share is going to be of 100 each. So number of shares will be divided by 100. So 14,000 will be the number of shares in option 1. And in option 2, 20 lakhs into 50% equity divided by 100. So 10,000. Correct? So your EPS will be this divided by this amount. This divided by number of shares. Correct? So that will be your EPS. Now what we are saying is, what is EBIT indifference level at this EBIT indifference level of X rupees? EPS should remain same. So that now we are forming a simultaneous equations. We are forming simultaneous equations. So this equation should be equal to this because EPS is supposed to be same. So this equal to this. So we'll solve this equation for X, right? So solving this equation, opening the brackets, you will get the value of X. So X comes to 2,20,000 rupees. So what it means is that if EBIT of the company is rupees 2,20,000, then at 2,20,000 rupees, it won't matter whether company goes for option 1 or option 2. Now, so obviously, if you replace X with 2,20,000, then your EPS will remain same. Let us quickly do that. So, you know, let me just for your understanding, let me show this 2,20,000 here itself, and then let us see what happens to our EPS, right? So 2,20,000, then your profit before tax will be this minus interest, 25% is your tax, correct? 25% of this amount. So profit after tax will be profit before tax minus tax, right? Number of shares, these. So what happens to your EPS? PAT divided by number of shares, it is 8.25, and in option 2 also, this divided by number of shares, 8.25, correct? So it is proven now that at 2,20,000 EBIT, it won't matter to the company whether company goes for option 1 or 2, because shareholders will have the same amount of EPS, right? So that's the relevance of your EBIT indifference level. Now, how it is used? Now, this is the calculation part. Now, the next part is that you should know as a management accountant how it is used in reality. So now what it means is, let us say that, you know, company is estimating that its actual EBIT is going to be 2,50,000 rupees, which is higher than the indifference level of 2,20,000. So what does it mean? So if company is estimating that its actual EBIT is going to be higher than EBIT indifference level, then from EPS point of view, company should always go for higher debt. So higher debt is in option 2. So in such case, it is better company goes for option 2. Let us see. So if 2,50,000 is your EBIT, interest we have already calculated, same as here, correct? Profit before tax will be EBIT minus interest, 25% will be the tax on that, remaining amount will be profit after tax divided by number of shares. Your EPS is 9.86 in option 1 and 10.50 in option 2. So see, now you can see option 2 gives us more EPS. So which means if EBIT amount is likely to be more than the indifference level, then it is better to go for higher debt option. However, if the estimated EBIT is likely to be lesser than the indifference level, so let us say that, you know, the EBIT is 1,90,000 rupees, right? So then it is always better to be conservative and go for the option with lesser debt. So which is option 1 in our case, correct? So option 1 was only 30% debt. So what will happen? Let us see the calculation. So if EBIT is 1,90,000 minus interest, 66,000 and 1,10,000, which is same as earlier. Profit before tax will be EBIT minus interest. 25% of that amount will be tax. Remaining amount will be PAT. And number of shares, same as earlier, 14,000 and 10,000. So PAT upon number of shares, you will see EPS 6.64 here, and here it is 6. So now you'll notice it is exactly the other way around. So now option 1 gives greater EPS as compared to option 2. Why it happened? Because our EBIT is likely to be lesser than the EBIT indifference level. So this is how the you know, the use of EBIT indifference level is actually you know, there in reality. So what you need to know is how to first calculate the EBIT indifference level, and secondly, after calculating, how to use that. So once you calculate EBIT indifference level, see, whenever the company wants to raise funds, additional funds, you know, company always has multiple options of debt equity. So then company has to decide which option to be selected. So how to select that, you know, that depends on EBIT indifference level and the estimated level of EBIT. So I repeat, if actual EBIT is estimated to be higher than EBIT indifference level, then it is always better to go for an option with higher debt, because that delivers higher EPS to the shareholders. However, if estimated EBIT is expected to be lesser than the EBIT indifference level, then it is better to be conservative and go for that option, which is with a lesser debt, because then that will give higher EPS to the shareholders. All right. So I hope you have understood how to first of all calculate the EBIT indifference level, And the calculation happens by simultaneous equation method, as we discussed, as we saw, and you know how to use that EBIT indifference level in reality. All right. So if you have liked this video, my request would be subscribe to this channel and click on the bell icon so that whenever new videos are uploaded by me, you will keep getting notifications. So thank you. This is Professor Anil Joshi. I will be uploading all commerce related videos on this channel. Thank you very much.